I've spent a couple of hours this morning searching for a good place to set up my hide. Initially, I set up here, and I have a great view up and down the stream, but I was not comfortable with being so close to the bank and to the water. I've come back to this little stream here. It's still not ideal, but it is very natural looking, and I've got a view up the stream and down the stream. Both views are a little bit blocked by vegetation, but maybe that will also help to conceal me in my hide. I think I'm going to set up just down behind me here, and then I'll have a view down the stream over there. And maybe if something comes down to drink or fishing in that water, I'll get it quite a clear view on that side. But the thing that's got me very excited is I just brought my camera here and just put that down, and just beyond that bamboo over there, there was a very large snake. I didn't get a clear view of it or any view. It just shot off, went shooting back through the forest, quite a decent size, and very fast, so a rat snake, I would guess. And that's the kind of thing I would just love to see. You know, you can't replace or mimic that kind of natural behavior that you will get from an animal when you're in a hide and the animal has no idea you're here. You might get nothing, or you might only get a few seconds, but it's just worth so much more than anything that you can set up yourself in an artificial situation. So it's already nearly 12 o'clock. It's taken me a long time to get to this point today, but there's still about 4 or 5 hours of decent light left in the day, so I'm going to set up my hide here and see what comes along. Oh. Having some trouble with this hide, the poles are old. Oh, join the club, eh? There we go. That's one side, isn't it? I'll try and get the other side now. In there. I want to use this proper hide here so that I can be a bit more comfortable with the cloak. You can't really move around inside, and I've got that. My binoculars and my camera bag and everything. With this one, I'll have room to put everything inside, as well as myself. Okay, where to put it? Okay, looks pretty good. I'm on a slope, as so often when I use hides, you end up on a slope. You just have to deal with that. But it's a much better view than I had before. Right, let's get everything inside and see what comes along.
Kaeng Krachan has a wonderful array of wildlife. Many people come here for bird watching, but I'm really keen to try to get some film of mammals. Leopards and sun bears are seen in this area quite frequently, and I think my best chance of getting some good film of one of the larger mammals is from a hide.
Okay, let's get inside. All right, this is not exactly ideal. If it was on my own land, I would set the hide up long in advance so the animals could get used to it and I wouldn't be doing all this disturbing. But this is a national park. You can't just leave hides lying around like that. But anyway, I'm quite happy with this now. I've got a good view down that river, and I'm up a little bit from the stream level, so it won't be so easy for animals to get my scent or to see that I'm here. All right, good. I'm gonna get myself into a chair and have a little drink and then see if we get something coming. There's my view. I have the netting down at the front. As you saw, the monitor went off. I set it to go off quite quickly to save battery. And then, Oh, wrong side. Let's go over the other side. This is the view through the netting, so every now and then I do open it up a little bit so I can get a clearer view outside along the river. There we are. Then there's windows on each side as well, which I open up. Have a little sneaky look outside as carefully as I can.
Well, I didn't have to wait long before I got an amazing surprise. This shot is horribly blurred, but that illustrates the problem of filming everything on manual when animals are moving fast in and out of shade, and I've included it here just to illustrate that point. After a few moments, this monitor lizard settled down to sunbathe right in front of me for about 10 minutes. And I realized for the first time that it was not the common water monitor, but the very rarely seen black rough-necked monitor. And my heart was pounding, I can tell you. These are just a few outtakes. I have a full video on my encounter with this monitor lizard, and the link is at the end of the clip.
Wow. That's the jackpot. That's just unbelievable to have an animal actually not just pass by, but stop and sunbathe for about 10 minutes right in front of my hide. Absolutely incredible. It's still just walking downstream a little bit. It was flicking its tongue out a lot, as you saw there. I thought it was actually going to come into my hide. I rather foolishly brought some snacks with me, just some dry fruit and peanuts in here. I'm not sure if that smell from that food has been traveling far from the hide or not. It started to come up toward the bank towards me, but it's headed off in the direction of where I saw the snake earlier. If that snake was a king cobra, I think it might be an interesting encounter, because king cobras will eat this kind of monitor lizard, of course. And that's the first time I've seen this species as well, so that was just absolutely magical. My goodness. I'd only been waiting here about an hour and a half, which in terms of working with hides is not very much at all, but up until that point nothing had happened, and I was beginning to wonder if I'd made a bad choice again for location. But that, I mean, if you sit for all day and you get that, it's absolutely worth it. Fantastic. I can still hear it walking, actually, so I'll stop talking because it might come back down again.
Well, I did get some other visitors through the rest of the afternoon. A spotted forest skink here. There is always stuff to see when you are near water.
It's about 4:30 now. I came in here about 12:30, so it's been a really nice 4 hours. The highlight, of course, was the monitor. Fantastic. But I saw a few other little things there, and I've got... And as you could hear, I hope, a lot of bird calls around me as well. I had the brown hornbill calling, the crested serpent eagle as well. But I'm going to have to think about packing up now in the next half hour, because I need to leave the park about
6 o'clock before it gets dark, or as it's getting dark. And that'll leave me 1 hour just to cruise slowly along the road on my way out. And maybe, just maybe, it'll be my turn to see a leopard on the side of the road one of these days.